Hi, Doug Masnaghetti here with another guitar lesson. This one's on Jethro Tull's Mother Goose. This lesson is organized like all my lessons. I'm going to do a quick intro here. I'll move into a cover real quickly, and then I'll do the lesson. So if you want to skip the intro and the cover and move straight to the lesson, you can go ahead and fast forward. So the album, this was released on Jethro Tull's Aqualung album in 1971. And as far as I can tell, it's just a song about the colorful characters that he meets, you know, at a fair. And that's really all it's about, as far as I can tell. Now, there was one line that always, I never really made sense of. It's in the third verse, and it's Johnny Scarecrow, saw Johnny Scarecrow make his rounds in his jet black Mac. I'm not a Brit. I don't know what a Mac is. I always, as a kid, I pictured him driving around in his black Mack truck. But what it is an old style raincoat, if you will. A guy named Macintosh, and so they used to call these coats Macintoshes. The computer is not the first product to be named Macintosh. It's just basically rubberized, that stiff rubberized material that you can get garments made out of. It was invented sometime in the 1800s. I think Macintosh patented it. Anyway, that's what the jet black Mac is. It makes a lot more sense as to how we could have stole it off a snowman. So I don't know. If you're as illiterate as I am, maybe that's enlightening. So I think that's about all the trivia I have on the song. So without further ado, here's the cover.
I don't believe they knew.
So you either just watched or skipped over the cover of Mother Goose. The song is played with capo on the fifth fret, and let me just make sure I'm centered a little better here. You want to make sure that you're in tune once you put this capo on, because you're pretty far up the neck, and unless you can adjust the tension on the capo, there's a tendency for the strings to go sharp on you, and you really want to be in tune for this song, because it's it is an acoustically heavy song. I start out with just sort of strumming using this E minor shaped chord that's moved over a set of strings. So I'm covering the second frets of the third and the fourth string. It's like a partial D9 chord, I guess. So I just start by, so it's, you hit the fifth string, you down strum, I down strum again, then I up strum, and then I down strum again, but this time when I have my fingers off when I strum and I hammer them on. Okay, so it's... start introducing on every other time through, instead of doing the hammer on every other time, you just leave these fingers in place and you put the ring finger and the pinky covering the third fret of the second and the third fret of the first string. So it sounds like this. That's the very catchy part of this whole song. It really sounds cool. Now this chord, as far as I can tell, that is no recognizable chord. I don't think that fits any formal chord definition. So I don't know how they come up with this stuff, but they did. So that's the way this song starts. And then when you want to get into the verse, right after you do that, you hit the fifth string, hit the fourth string with covering it with your first your index finger on the second fret. When you hit the fifth string, it's an open. So second fret on the fourth, and you hit it twice, and then on the second time you hit, you slide it up. So like that, and then you hit an open third string, an open second string, an open third string again, and then you hit an open fourth string, but as soon as you do, you hammer on to the second fret and the fourth fret, and then you take off and actually hit it with your pick. Don't do it. You can do a pull-off if you want, but I think it sounds better if you hit it with a pick. Because you're singing during this period, and you're only playing single notes, and you really want them to, not be completely overpowered by the vocals that's going on. So you want those notes to come through. And so I think it sounds better if you don't do a pull-off on that last bit. But let me just do that real slow for you. So I just showed you. Showed you earlier, I should say, and then I just showed you this in a second. Now, and then you go into this partial D9 chord again. Okay, so. Okay, so all I'm doing is lifting off and putting them back on alternating pick strokes, okay? So I think you can see both hands here. off and then you hammer them back on. So. Okay. And then he moves into a C shape. And he hits it twice. Back on C twice. Pull them off, put them back on C twice. Hit that fifth string open and go into the D9 partial routine again. Alright, so try to play through it one more time slow. I hope I broke that down enough for you. Okay, so the chorus that you then go into starts out with a D kind of a D configuration. So I'm covering the second frets of the first and the third string, and the third fret on the second string. And he emphasis on this fourth string. Reach out and grab hold of the fifth string on the fourth fret. And you want to hit again on this D configuration, but try to emphasize the fourth string, so it like that, and then you move your index finger onto the second fret of the fifth and return it immediately to a D as you hit the fourth string and some of the strings involved in the D chord. So that's just a G, and I'm covering the first and the second string on the third fret, the fifth string on the second fret, and the sixth string on the third fret. And you do this kind of a deal, just strumming back and forth, D chord again, and then you go to A. I can't remember what variation on an A chord this is, unfortunately, but I'm covering the second frets of the second string and the fourth string. And then you pull your ring finger off the second string and put it back on. So it's. Slow if I can. Let me make sure I'm in the camera here. Whoops. And the second time through, he ends going into a C chord. I don't believe they knew I was a school born. So, during that C chord, don't believe that do I was a schoolboy. I do like to take my ring finger on and off the fourth string. I don't believe that you. I was a schoolboy. Okay, and so that's the whole song. There's a riff that occurs twice in the song. It occurs between the second and third verse, and then it occurs at the very end of the song. And I, a lot of times, will start actually with the riff, start the song, so I end up playing it three times. All right, so let me see if I can prattle through it here. I'm gonna, you know, rather than just starting the riff, I'm gonna lean into it. That's what it sounds like. That's, I think that's pretty close. Some of my timing may be off. So let me just run through it real quick. So you start it with index finger covering the second string, first fret. Pick it. Let me make sure I'm in the screen. Pick it and hammer on to the third fret on second string, and then hit the first string, and then come back and hit the second string again. Now, when you hit, that's the third time. You started with the second string, you hammer it on, so that would count as two, and then the first string, and then you come back, that's three. So the third time, you want to sustain that note a little bit before you move back into it. So, and then you run through the exact same sequence again, where you start with the second string covered on the first fret, hammer on, first string, but now when you come back to the second string, pull off your ring finger off the third fret, so you're now just covering the first fret of the second string, and again you want to sustain on that note. So, sorry, you don't want to sustain on that note. You want to sustain on the next note, which is after you hit the second string. When you're covering it on the first fret, you drop your middle finger onto the second fret of the third string, and you hit it, and that's what you want the sustain on. So it sounds like this. And then you move into this cool little sequence where you just drop your index finger onto the second fret of the fourth string, and you hit it, and then the third string, and then on an up pick, because you need to be efficient, it's real fast, on an up pick, you hit the second string. And so both the third and the second strings are just opens, right? So, and then you cover the fourth fret of the fourth string, and do it again. And then you pull your ring finger off the fourth fret. You're covering the second fret of the fourth string. You hit it. You hit it open, the fourth string open. And then with your middle finger, go to the third fret of the fifth string and do that little triad sequence again, where you're going to hit an open fourth and an open third, and hit that third with an up pick. And then you will take your middle finger off and put your index finger onto the second fret of the fifth string. Hit it. Hit an open. Then hit the sixth string covered on the third fret. And now let me just play through that. And I'm not sure. I think you may go down here. Let me just play through this real slow, though. So I show you the beginning already, right? Yeah, that's the last note before you move into an open five. Now, depending on whether you're doing this in between verses, if you're doing it in between verses, you use that open fifth string as the intro to. or if you're at the end of the song, you hit that string and follow through and just strum off the thing, and that's the very end of the song. So that's the little riff. Now, I did want to say something about the vocals. So I found it, you know, I'm just probably a page or two ahead of you. If you're watching this as a, you know, trying to learn from this, you're a student of this. So a lot of this stuff I'm just sort of figuring out as I'm, you know, documenting it. So I wanted to say a couple of things about the lyrics. I found it tricky when I was doing this song to you know, get my lyrics timed with the individual notes that he's picking during the verse. And so just a quick tip, you know, to help those that might struggle with this. You know, I'm sure some watching this are, you know, way ahead of me on vocalization. So let's see, it's this part. And it opens with, as I did walk by Hampstead Fair, right? So when do you go into it? That was what I was having trouble with. And you hit, so you're doing this. As I did walk by Hampstead Fair. So you're doing the little shuffle, right? And you're getting ready to launch into the verse. You hit an open fifth, and then you're going to hit this string twice. Remember, you slide up, and then you hit an open three, and you hit an open two, and then you do the hammer-on thing, and then, right? So you want to enter, you want to start that particular verse, as I did walk by Hampstead Fair. You hit the open five, no singing yet. So hit the open five, then hit the four covered on the second fret, and you it's the second time you hit that. You're gonna hit that twice. If you've played through this at this point, you'll remember. You're gonna hit it twice, and so on the second time you hit it, that's when you start as. If you do it that way, you'll find that the notes follow the pitch of your voice as you're singing it. So on the other nearly all other parts except in the last verse, he begins with an and at each verse. So, and a foreign student said to me. So when it's any of the lines that are opening with an and a lot of them do. You start it on the first time that you hit the fourth string on the second fret. So for instance, as I did walk by Hampstead Fair, compared to. I started that the first time I hit that string. So anyway, I just thought I'd throw that tip out there. I found it made things a lot easier. Now, at the end of the song, the last verse, there's the line about saw Johnny Scarecrow make his rounds in his jet black Mac. That also starts just like as I passed by Hampstead Square. It starts when the second time you're hitting the fourth string covering the second fret. So what I do, because it just makes it easier for me, is I insert and. I don't if you're following the lyrics literally, never be afraid to toss an and in. And the very last portion of the verse, he's repeating the introduction where he says, as I pass by Hampstead Fair. That time through it, I put an and in front of it, and I just sing it, start it with the first pluck of the fourth string right there, second fret. Okay, I think that's it. I think I covered it all. Hope it wasn't too confusing. Good luck.